Hi, I'm Sangeeta Krishnan and I welcome you on behalf of Jagran Josh to this week's video. So first, I'll take you through the main headlines of the week, then I'll come to the main topic of discussion for today. The main headlines of the week are Om Prakash Rawat appointed as new Chief Election Commissioner. Senior-most Election Commissioner Om Prakash Rawat succeeded Anchal Kumar Jyoti as the new Chief Election Commissioner in the Election Commission on 21st January 2018. Anandibeen Patel sworn in as Governor of Madhya Pradesh. Former Gujarat Chief Minister Anandibeen Patel was sworn in as the new Governor of Madhya Pradesh on 23rd January 2018. WEF launches Global Center for Cyber Security. The World Economic Forum on 24 January 2018 launched a Global Center for Cyber Security to safeguard the world against hackers and growing data breaches. Swachh Bharat Mission Urban launches Smart Star rating for garbage-free cities. This initiative basically would rate the cities on a 7-star rating system, which would be based on multiple cleanliness indicators for solid waste management. India becomes member of Australia Group. India on 19 January 2018 joined the Australia Group Export Control Regime, an informal group that seeks to ensure that exports do not contribute to the development of chemical and biological weapons. So this is the topic that I will be discussing in detail with you today. India has become the 43rd member of the Export Control Regime. This development is expected to raise India's stature in the field of non-proliferation and also help it acquire critical technologies. So now let's come to what is the Australia Group. It is basically an informal forum of countries that seek to ensure that exports do not contribute to the development of chemical and biological weapons through the harmonization of export control. The coordination of export control measures assists the Australia Group members to fulfill their obligations under Chemical Weapons Convention and Toxic and Biological Weapons Convention to the fullest extent possible. Now coming to India's inclusion in the group, India is the latest entrant into the group. It is also the first South Asian nation to become the group's full-time member. The development is expected to enhance India's credentials in the field of non-proliferation, even though India is not a signatory to the Non-Proliferation Treaty. Basically, ever since India signed the civil nuclear deal with the United States, it has been wanting to get into these multilateral export regimes such as the Nuclear Supplies Group, the Australia Group, the Wassenaar Arrangement and the Missile Technology Control Regime. These export control regimes mainly regulate nuclear, biological, conventional and chemical weapons and technologies. India became the 42nd member of the Wassenaar Arrangement on 7 December 2017. And before that, in June 2016, it became a full-time member of the Missile Technology Control Regime. Hence, this inclusion into the Australia Group strengthens India's bid to enter the 48-member Nuclear Suppliers Group. And significantly, China, which stalled India's entry into the Nuclear Suppliers Group, is not a member of the Wassenaar Arrangement or the Australia Group or the Missile Technology Control Regime. So with this, I conclude my topic for today. Please like and comment if you like our video. You can also visit our website www.jagranjosh.com for more updates and download our Jagran Josh current affairs app to stay connected.